What's up, guys? We are back in the workshop today with my miter saw because for today's project, we're playing with wood. Now, in yesterday's video, we tried making something called green sand, which is basically play sand that you can use for casting metals. And I went ahead and mixed up a whole bunch more, so now we've got about 25 pounds of green sand just ready to be used. So the good news is we now have some good quality sand to work with. The bad news is we still need a sandbox to use it with. So that's what we're doing here today. With some simple and low-cost materials, we're building ourselves a set of metal casting sandboxes. Now I just ran down to the hardware store and picked up one of these 8-foot lengths of 1x3 pine board. These things are extremely cheap, extremely common, and the two things you want to watch for is to get a piece that doesn't have too many knots in it, and make sure it's relatively straight when you look down the edge. Now to keep things relatively simple, our first sandbox is going to be on the smaller side. And we can get started making it by cutting our length of pine board into 8 sections, 7 inches long. So update guys, all of our 8 pieces are now cut and all of them are exactly the same length. In fact, just to be sure, after they were cut, I lined all of them up together and sliced one more time down the edge just to make sure they lined up perfectly smooth. Now since we were chopping up wood anyway and we had some left over, I cut these two pieces 5 inches long and another piece 20 inches long, and you'll see what all these are for in just a minute. So here's the basic idea. We're going to take these 4 pieces of wood and set them down on the table so 2 pieces are parallel to each other, and we'll use the other 2 pieces to cap them from the top and the bottom. Now because we're going to be ramming sand into our system, we want to screw these together. But just for convenience, I'm going to be using my brad nailer to tack them together and hold them in place until we can drill some pilot holes and set the screws. So here we are guys, I went ahead and drilled pilot holes in each of the 4 corners and added a screw to bind them down tightly, and now we have 2 nearly identical wooden frames that fit together just about perfectly. Now the purpose of the screws in the corners here is to bind the wooden pieces together tight, because once we start ramming sand down in there, it's going to apply a lot of pressure to the inside walls, and if it's just nails holding that in there, it's going to fall apart. Alright, cool, so we got our 2 little box frames finished. Let's go ahead and bring back these 5-inch pieces now and use them to create some latches. Now if you look really closely at these blocks, you can see I've just cut little triangles out of them, and I did that by stacking them together so they're perfectly symmetrical and using the edge of another piece of board as a guide to draw a triangle. Both of these pieces went into the jaws of my bench vise to be held securely in place, where I could then use a jigsaw to trace out the pattern. So now we have 2 little wooden puzzle pieces whose triangles fit perfectly inside. Let's go attach them to the box. We're going to need these wooden frames stacked together as perfectly as possible, so for convenience I'm going to be using clamps. They're not necessary, but it is going to make the job a lot easier. Take your block of wood and flip it around so your triangle is pointing upward, then separate the 2 pieces and place them on the side of your box. We want to place this on the side of our box with the triangle on the bottom piece facing upward, but it's very important that the tip of it is below the center line. When the spacing looks good, you can take the second piece and lock it into place on top of the triangle. Center everything up so that it looks good, and then go ahead and screw it into place. So check it out guys, our little metal casting sandbox is just about finished. You can see I used 2 screws to screw the triangle into place, and then 2 screws on the top support as well as 2 temporary screws on the bottom support. Those are designed to come out, and when they do, the 2 halves will separate. And for convenience, you can see I've added a few extra markings because once the 2 sides separate, it's important to know which way they go back together. On the 2 ends, I drew 2 lines and added some arrowheads so we know exactly where these are supposed to line up. And on the front side, I put an F on the triangle as well as the top piece, and the back side got the letter B. See, now the system's foolproof because if you try and put it together backwards, it won't fit and it will tell you why. Flip it around and it goes together like a glove. So there we have it, guys. Our little wooden sandbox is finished and ready for metal casting. And just for fun, I put together a couple more so we have a couple of different options for casting different size items. They're made exactly the same. The only difference is this box is 10x10, whereas this is 7x7. And you can see what a dramatic difference that extra 3 inches makes to the volume inside. All right, cool, so our sandboxes are made, but there are a couple more tools we're gonna need before we jump into our metal casting projects. So let's make those next. So quick update, guys. I just took a few minutes and put together a whole array of new tools. Let me show you what we got. First of all, I used some half-inch MDF to make some molding boards. You can see on the back they've got base rails. These are designed to sit on top of our boxes and hold the sand in place as we flip them over. We also have a scrap piece of 1x3, and this is going to be used as a straight edge to help level off the sand. Next up, we've got a couple of ramming tools. These are simply 8-inch lengths of 2x2 and are used for pounding the sand into place. I also cut a couple of 8-inch lengths of these 1¼-inch dowels to act as sprues, and I threw one of them on the belt sander for a few minutes to give it this tapered edge, which should help it pop out a little bit cleaner. If we need our sprues to be a little thinner in diameter, I cut some 3/4-inch PVC that should serve the same purpose, and I cut out a piece of 12-gauge home electrical wire that we can use to poke vent holes. This funny-looking piece of metal here is a strip that I cut from the bottom of an Altoids tin, and it's a tool we can use to carve out some channels or gates leading to the castings we're gonna make. It almost sounds like I know what I'm talking about, but I don't. This is actually my first experience, my first attempt with any of this. And the purpose of these videos is to share my experiences with you as I do. We've got our sand, we've got our tools, so the next thing to try is green sand casting. Thanks for joining me for this project, guys. Hope you learned something new. I'll see you in the next video. Talk to you then. Pretty cool looking box, actually. I don't even know what they're called. Metal casting sandboxes, sure. Hey guys, quick reminder that limited time King of Random t-shirts are now on sale. Click the link at the top of the description or visit randomgear.com. See you there.